To there. Cheddarbug in the middle feels a little bit better to me for the escapability and the option of ulting across to either side of the map.
Just depends on what your intentions are, right? Like, you're getting more levels in the long lane. Do you want a higher level Persephone or a higher level Cheddarbug?
I think I want Prime on it. Let's find out what the casters have to say.
Well, let's see if it is indeed going to be Prime that pilots a Persephone, as Breeze already under some trouble in this early game. It's Finch and Aggro. We might not have time for intros if Breeze is already under duress here this early on. Really easy gank for Frostyak or for Breeze. I think that Olerun's super strong. Breeze in trouble. Breeze in more than trouble. He's absolutely done. First blood picked up by Queso with a nice blink.
Olerun's kind of get through the lane phase.
Yeah, Frostyak got him. Wants to try and catch him in between the tier 1 and tier 2, and he's correct. That is it. Check.
Spudio gets that one, just assuming there's no way they wait for him between tier 1 and tier 2 here, right? Unfortunately, for Checkio, wrong, and this is what you should be doing to Olerun. Don't give him the free laning phase.
Let's see if they can successfully strip away this purple Frosty. Gets pinned against the wall, takes way too much damage. Spudio does hit a good crystallized curse, and in comes Breeze to follow up. The last breath should be enough on Draco Marino there as well. What a fight there from Outcold to turn around a pretty tough spot.
That was beautiful.
Queso, or rather Outcold, able to turn that around and then start looking for some good fights up there near that top side of the map. But here's the internal back for Dimmy with no help with that ultimate, and they pin him against the wall.
Dimmy locked in that animation. That's exactly where you don't want to be, in that Blade Storm as soon as Horse Turtle comes in. If you initiate right next to the Smite World Championships, really the beginning of Smite Worlds, the best.
Breeze, though, not having the best time right now. He gets pulled by Julio right back into the Fear No Evil. Spudio has used the ultimate, but it doesn't look for Frosty a bit too late, and Draco makes it out.
That's tough. Breeze finds the ultimate onto Julio, but there's a full health tier with a Lawbringer ultimate. Oh! Is that gonna help them get this kill, or?
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
okay. Yeah. That was.
Decided it's time. They've got all five members here, and they do secure the Pyromancer, but there will be a fight on the back end. Worst Turtle's already
oh,
left.
Yeah.
In comes the Persephone ult, right in the center of everything. That's perfect for Prime, but it's still Dimmy who's in trouble. Checkio's Sanctified Field might have been even better, but a two-man tectonic shift comes through for Frostyak. That's what you like to see. A triple kill for Spuddy. Hello.
Watch out. He's got another one lined up, but Warchi is just able to jump away in time. Julio might still be the quadra for Spuddio if he can land the autos.
A little too late now. But they are going to try and start the fight anyway. Worst Triple has used the Fear No Evil, but Outcold already got the Oni. Look how low Checkio is. If it wasn't for that Sanctified Field, he'd already be dead. But he was still able to buy himself a little bit of time. But Spudio not going to let him escape for free. Draco Marino now low as well. But man, just to worm his way back underneath the tower. Spudio makes into the wall as well. But where does he go from here? Warchi had the read. No way. Straight up and down the second he came out.
That was sick. Another sick Fearless coming from Julio. We'll get the beads out from Pretty Prime and the leap away. What looked like it was going to be a nuts fight for Outcold is not going well now.
No, it isn't. It's turned around. I think they might have pushed a little bit too far. Breeze is coming in to try and change the texture of this one. Warchi hit by the Cobra's Kiss. Frostyak here as well. Maybe low HP, but not low on damage. Prime gets to Warchi, but Julio finds some blood of his own. It really is a bloodbath as a horse turtle comes crashing back down to earth.
And Prime just jumping around this team fight in and out with that flourish. Has to use Aegis, but still has it. And Flourish should be up soon, but Julio's still hunting.
Julio is going to try and catch up. That'll be the damage Draco. Julio blinks in, only finds Spudio with that Fearless. Meanwhile, Frostyak has to deal with the Sanctified Field. Gets away from the Olerun damage, but not the Axe. And Orchi has been on fire here on this Uller so far. In goes Worst Turtle towards the back line. He wants Prime, but a good shell keeps everyone alive for now.
Spudio going to use his ultimate just to slow everybody down, get his cooldowns back. Dimmy finds Draco Marino. Dimmy still wants to brawl, but the rest of Outcold's on the run.
I feel like someone's got to make sure they get to Warchi. When he's allowed to free cast back there, it's
but he just can't deal the damage. Needs Obsidian Shard.
And in these skirmishy fights, Prime's damage is going to be weaker than pre-planned ones. As Breeze bleaks in, Fire Giant low, and Queso successfully grabbed the objective. Horse Turtle hunts down Prime. But remember, Prime can still put some damage out even in this dead state. There's the ultimate, and that's enough to take down Horse Turtle. Julio jumps into it as well.
Julio still is able to get out for at least a minute in Watery Grave. Disrupts Spudio's dash long enough. Beads will not be enough for him. Queso even it up at 11 in the kills, but the game feels like it's solidly in their favor.
It is starting to swing that way, and I think that I was trying to allude to it, so let me know if I'm on base here, man, but when Persephone, as Breeze falls, has to do those long fights that start
around killing the backline, can't really help out too much on that front line.
Moreno steps forward yet again. You said this is where Kuzumo can struggle to initiate. So Frosty does on the side of Out Cold. Phoenix has already gone down. Sanctified Field right in the thick of it. But there's the ultimate from Prime from downtown. And Draco Moreno finally removed.
Dimmy doing what he can. Spudio going to join the fray. It's a quick double kill for him. And he's looking for three.
That's a triple kill now for Spudio. Make that one a quadra kill. Full on DSI for Out Cold Gaming. Get out of our house, Queso. That's how you kick down the fire. Agreed. They are indeed going to let Worst Turtle do more than push out. Good flourish. Prime, but it's not enough. Worst Turtle able to use the leap to get in there and finish the kill. Julio blinks over, and he's found Breeze, but this Cerquette is decently tanky. But Draco Moreno and Julio should have him now isolated from any backup, and Checkio gets that much-needed kill. Out Cold lose two.
Man, that's such a bad fight from Out Cold. You do everything right. You do everything really well. And then Prime's ultimate, again, you have to wait until that CC immunity is gone from these frontliners. Julio has the ultimate available. They try and CC lead, chain him, but it doesn't work, and Breeze actually ends up hurting more than helping by guaranteeing a big stun.
Well, Demi has now moved in, and suddenly Orchi, who's low, stuck on the fire ring, is in trouble. He's not even going to contest the objective anymore. It's about finding the kill. Queso grabbed the FG, and Demi takes off Orchi, a priority target. Fear No Evil comes out from Worst Turtle, but he's going to end up dying there to Frostyak no matter what.
Dimmy has that Excalibur's Wrath, but a big ultimate from Checkio forces him back.
But a two-man stun from Dimmy is the response.
Uh-oh.
Frostyak with a double kill drops the Tectonic Shift and Spudio right there to respond. Julio falls as well. This game is like a tennis match. Certainly is an option here. Blink in for Frost. He goes right for Checkio. Draco Moreno blinks in as well, but Prime has used the ultimate already to guarantee Checkio is pushed into the grave. Draco Moreno still low here on the front line and no damage onto the Phoenix, but look at Frostyak's positioning. I don't think they expected him way in the back, and Draco Moreno falls for a double. Spudio finds Julio as well.
Now it's going to be looking good for Out Cold Gaming. Prime's very low though. Spudio still plenty healthy. Another multi-kill for Spudio.
Man.
And Prime's ghost can walk in and help him end.
What does Spudio have to do, it seems like, sometimes, right, to close one of these games out? Well, he finally ends up doing it Out Cold.
T here. In the Fields of Love, you're going to have a bad time.
It might be Cupid middle, actually, now that I think about it. Kronos might go in the long lane if you can get the levels onto the Kronos. I would rather have it on Kronos than the Cupid. More teamfight potential with the Fields of Love, so stick
That's
it
true.
In mid.
That's true. We'll find out then if the Cupid's going to be mid lane. I think Tolly might be right. Can Queso answer back? I asked that of the casters.
I think they certainly can. There are plenty of answers from in game one, just not quite enough as Out Cold grabbed that game. But
Cupid does not excite me 35 minutes into the game. Doesn't really get the juice flowing.
Orchi, they did so much to slow him down on this retreat path. First blood for Frostyak, but that was good obelisk placement, good walls. They had everything to slow down Orchi.
That obelisk was hot fire. That was so good from Pretty Prime. You called it though. I mean, Orchi's dash is very linear. It goes one direction, you know exactly where it's going to be.
Worst Turtle might be in some trouble now too, as Frostyak is taken to the sky. Can't find the stun. I like the idea to try and go for the CC immunity on the last breath, but it's just not. Find himself meeting up with Worst Turtle, Checkio, and Draco Moreno. Queso in the wrong side of the map, getting aggressive. It's because the red buff spawning. Worst Turtle catches the worst of it, but is able to get out of there thanks to a Gev shield. That will be the Cataclysm going out from Draco, but it doesn't save his life. He falls for the third kill for Out Cold unanswered.
Orchi has already isolated. You can force him back pretty easily.
Spudio now in a bit of trouble. He's been hit by Cobra's Kiss Death Bane and needs some peel coming in from Breeze stat.
Sick
it definitely
juke.
Works. But Draco Marino's coming in. There were just too many attempts on Spudio's life for him to survive. Checkio eventually gets the credit. And Breeze is going to fall as well. Suddenly, Queso have two picks of their own. The duo lane of old, in quotes,
getting him down, but not very high on the mana department.
Still battling it out anyway. Hard to convince this guy on King Arthur to leave. He has a target. Frostyak took to the sky, lands on Draco Moreno, and they find themselves a pick. Now suddenly it's Julio fighting a bit by himself. There's the Fields of Love. Just came off cooldown from Warchi, and that should spell the end for Frostyak. A nice basic attack puts him in the dirt.
Oh, but Dimmy's doing too much right now, man. Just enough for getting Worst Turtle away. But Julio's still in some trouble. Prime doesn't have. Julio has got an option, looking for the blink, finds Breeze, he's dead.
Oh, for sure, Cataclysm is there too, Fields of Love just to guarantee it.
That's weird.
Bit of a bummer that Wurchi has to use that there. I don't know that he has if it had landed. Gold Fury started, but Frostyak dunks on four people. Not bad at all. They have the Sanctified Field waiting afterwards. Prime shreds through him at the Desert Fury, but Spudio has found two kills in this engagement. Julio is going to keep them from pushing any further forward, but they'll just settle for him instead. Spudio beads to keep pushing through the damage. Tries to catch out Checkio before he gets the rewind off, but it's not there.
Checkio does get rewind off indeed, but it'd be difficult for him to get away anyways. Prime and Dimmy hot on his heels. Dimmy gonna be able to chase him down. And that one, I could tell you exactly how.
Sure would be sick if Thor was ulted.
Man, I'm really glad Thor doesn't have ult. Guys, just immediately killed.
Where's Turtle? And the rest of the squad going aggressive. Good Cataclysm from Draco Moreno stuns both. And Worst Turtle gets a pretty nice pick there onto Frosty. They might not even be done. Breeze, Putson have got to decide how much they want to try and contest this. How much are they willing to commit? They don't even have Frosty, so this has to be light. Queso already took the Pyromancer, and now they're trying to see if they can bait out Colt into this fight. Dimmy takes Draco Moreno up to the sky, but still it's Queso with the numbers.
Perfect. Look at this CC chain on a Draco Moreno until Prime doesn't do it right. Impales him out of range, and now Dimmy gets punished.
And Warchi gets that kill credit. Frosty has now made his way in as well after using that Anvil of Dawn. But Queso are on the retreat path. But still, Alcoa won a little bit more despite having already lost Dimmy. Breeze starts stepping forward too. Frostyak incredibly low, but Worst Turtle has Blink. Last Breath guarantees the kill.
So weird that fight from Alcoa. Frostyak in particular. That one is rough. I mean,
find very much there, but they do have minions and Warchi threatening this tier one, and they grab the tower, Blink into the Cataclysm. They want Dimmy dead.
They'll get him. Checkio is able to get the last hit credit, but how will the fight go after?
That's the real big question. Sanctified Field already on cooldown, and Queso positioning like they still want a bit more. Warchi dashes in aggressively, had the heart bomb. His ultimate kind of by himself over here on the left hand side, so a lot of just kind of independent calls being made, it feels like, for both teams. And in goes Worst Turtle. Cobra's Kiss does pull in both Prime and Breeze. Now it's time for the spins to start coming out from Dimmy. But Frostyak's taken to the sky and hit another big ultimate and then immediately pays for it with his life.
Oh, Julio didn't get the message. The Sanctified Field was causing them to back up. But look at this, a couple blinks over the top. And we don't have to worry about it anymore.
Perfectly calculated, I guess we have to say, for Team Queso, as suddenly they're the ones running over out. Cold Checkio finds himself a double kill. Dimmy's been stunned by the heart bomb. You don't like grouping up with the King Arthur, but you love Checkio finding his way to a triple kill. A rampage, that means five in a row. The cloak, they're straight up fighting. It costs Draco his bubble as well. Breeze now plucking Julio back in. This has turned to an actual scuffle. Big ult from Spudio dissects the team fight, and Julio and Worst Turtle now isolate on the wrong side of the tracks. But it's Prime who needs some help. Big stun from Frosty, but Orchi looping around the backside blows up the honor.
Julio still half HP. Worst Turtle joins and immediately gets shown the door as Warchi's locked in, but he's got no damage to worry about. Checkio took care of Dimmy already.
Reclaim that one. Right side Phoenix starting to melt beneath Checkio's damage. Not quite as much you might expect here from Lacronos, but he's getting there as Spudio falls as well. This is starting to look like Team Queso might have this one wrapped up. Frostyak in some trouble. Aegis and Beads buy him some time, but even still, he can't make it all the way back to the fountain. Trying to get to the hammer, but can't make it. Checkio gets that kill, and Team Queso stretch us to a third game.
Hey, Julio's pretty good at tier. And Cupid's better than we thought.
Out of the Phoenixes to maybe confirm it that way.
It's a real goon squad of a team out called Gamer have drafted here. Like, that's all press W and run at them from this team. The only one that you're really probably going to want to sit back is that top for the artillery range. Whereas, you know, Queso's
That they wouldn't want to value.
She's good. I don't know. Draco Moreno's got a great path here. Did this to Prime at level 2 in game 1 of this set.
Give me the beads.
But now Prime is going to get punished because Worst Turtle's here as well. Same situation as the last, as game 1, where he's pulled out of ward coverage. You have to expend a lot more gold against the Morgan ADC than you often want to.
Breeze is in a lot of trouble now. Julio rotates in and finds another kill out cold. Starting to get a...
See Draco pick up the purification beads. Watch out. Checkio finds Prime. And has an ultimate as well, and Prime no beads.
But does use the Flourish to avoid the overhand smash. It's not enough, though. Checkio ends up getting pretty Prime as he drops. Prime can still return some damage in this form, though it is reduced. There's the actual ultimate coming out from Prime this time, and Spudio falls in trade. Final judgment coming through as the they find one more. Frostyak takes care of Orchi, suddenly out cold, finding some answers.
Oh, but here comes Julio up and over the top. Dimmy, fearless, good disarm.
Good damage.
But Dimmy has the skewer, and that's enough to bring down Draco.
And needs to get some of these slows out. That'll be what helps Frostyak make.
He'll be in trouble, so that's something that I think that you can use as we move forward.
There's the ultimate there from Frostyak. Orgy at half HP.
Yeah, that's
a perfect
good.
Snipe for Prime. He weaved that through. What a nutcase. See you later to Orgy.
That is, that's good. Terrific. Four or five people. You can win a team fight that way.
And again, if they don't beat, like you said, you can just take the win there. As Dimmy does get caught. He still has the Lawbringer. I doubt he's in that much, or not Dimmy with the Lawbringer, obviously, but he still has the ability to get over the wall. But there's too many members of Queso here. Dimmy can't make it out. Orgy is the one that gets that kill.
Little
tricky. It's Orchi that he pulls back to the ground, but Breeze might be too far forward. I'm getting excited, but there's no one there to follow up. Julio gets the kill, and now all of a sudden, Dimmy's following up too.
The Frostyak's in trouble. Chekio with a great angle to this team fight transforms into a Hunbats of his own. Is going to be able to get Spudio down.
Chekio gets that kill. Dimmy still hunting Orchi. Eventually claims that scalp. He'll look for Frostyak here as well. Gets that one. So a bit of a chaotic fight, but Queso do manage to find
not a whole lot of props.
Out cold could be in some trouble, particularly Prime. As goodness gracious, does Chekio swing? That was all his damage. And Prime, I mean, I know he can do some damage from the grave, but he's already been removed. Frostyak has a run as well as Horse Turtle starts to hunt him down. Chekio finds another two-man stun. He's had a sick fight here so far. At three members of Out Cold already down.
Spudio joins and is like, guys, where are we at?
Yeah. So this is all about baiting, it feels like, trying to force Out Cold into a bad spot. That is the flourish from Prime, but Breeze immediately steps on the gas. Fear no evil there from Frosty as well. Ultimate, maybe a little bit to be desired, but just in case it was needed, it was there. Now they'll take a look towards Worst Turtle instead, who makes it over the wall. But Dimmy the whole time has been in the back line.
Doing set stuff, man. Chasing down Warchi. Warchi no relics anymore. Gonna turn his attention towards Worst Turtle, but
what?
Julio, casual three-man fearless for the boy.
Had more value in that fight. His only fury looked by Out Cold.
Oh, that Spudio got his dash caught. He's dead. No way he lives.
Julio completes the rampage there with five in a row by taking the head off of Spudio. Out Cold, though, still slightly favored in this fight, you might think. But Julio, doing some work, has found his way towards Frostyak. He has been a nightmare on this tier all set long.
Just a little bit late on that Lawbringer. No blink for him, but doesn't seem to be ready to give up the chase because Worst Turtle's on the way.
Gets the tail end of it onto Frostyak that pulls him back in, but then he gets another Fearless onto another priority target, Breeze. We'll see you later as Case
down for Warchi for about 20 more. Dimmy has to expend that Kingslayer ultimate, but a lot of damage being put out. Final Judgment does clip Worst Turtle, but not a lot of damage.
Doesn't actually get the kill, but Chekio, he's had such a strong game. No reason for him to start slowing down now. Prime in some trouble, but Frostyak actually manages to find Warchi way, way in the back line. Breeze keeps Draco Marino out of things for most of the fight as well. These fights have been so back and forth, coming down to such slim margins as Draco blinks away from Frosty.
Frostyak is going to be able to find Draco Marino eventually. Frostyak's been
alive. Breeze with 9 lives.
Easy for him. Chekio already used that transformation into that Hunbat, but a big ultimate from Prime might be enough to turn the whole fight.
Frostyak finds a double kill somewhere in the middle of all of that. Final Judgment not quite enough there from Spudio, but Out Cold have managed to find themselves in
this. Draco has the ability. Warchi's axe obviously comes to mind.
Breeze, though, taking quite a bit of damage. There's the ultimate from Prime, and this time it lands in a great spot. Final Judgment is right there to follow up, and Warchi incredibly low. Dimmy able to do a good job cleaning it up, but it might cost him his life. Draco Marino answers back, but Spudio's having a fight to remember right now. Hieroglyphic Assault sets up for Frostyak to take out Chekio.
Draco taking damage from that Fear No Evil and actually a little bit on the back end. Great fight. And it starts with Pretty Prime. No beads? That is a tilt, man. I would be off this planet. I would be in orbit on Mars right now.
Well, it's flat, so if it tilted, you really could just fall right off, right?
Just straight off.
You got a giant wave in left, and this could be a good time for Queso to try and press matters further. Pretty Prime, point-blank ultimate to Worst Turtle space, but Breeze way too low. Chekio gets his head, but Frostyak answers back. Divine now with 9 in a row for Frostyak, but he's got to start to make the disengage.
Good damage coming through from Worst Turtle. That last breath ticking down, and it's just enough to get the shutdown.
Spudio charging the Final Judgment, but Draco Marino will not let him fire. If there's multiple members of Out Cold dead, Queso have the run of the map as Prime doing damage from the grave, and a good bit of it setting up for Spudio to maybe find a kill here. Lets the Final Judgment loose, but doesn't find it.
Julio's in a little bit of...
Yep. And they don't have anyone who can go in and just drop a big Cataclysm. The best is Frost. Yeah, dropping Fear No Evil. And that does catch Checkio making a rotation. He's now low and a bit vulnerable. So Demi willing to commit. But Checkio turns into the Fear No Evil to try and drop it, but it doesn't save him. Demi claims his life. In comes the ultimate from Prime, that trapped too, but Queso full-on disengaged. Ooh. Except for way down here, worst Turtle. A nice flick there from Spudia.
Really good turn and burn. Ooh. Pretty Prime with a bone rush as well. Flattens worst Turtle. And now it's a...
Loses the Mad Guy's cloak, but wants to try and force something. He's used all of his abilities to move in aggressively. This feels like a lapse in judgment here from worst Turtle, and it might end up costing. The Final Judgment comes through. Still not enough for the kill. Breeze with a sash finally claims his life. Worst Turtle goes down. But out cold, haven't done much more than that just yet.
Julio's in trouble, though, but not a lot of ultimates left on the table. Demi, the only one who still has his available.
Julio is indeed low, and Frostyek finally gets him. 66 minutes, that's such a long time to ask for Worst Turtle to keep making really good choices, and I think he might finally have shown a few cracks there, as this has looked like it might be the push that out cold need.
This could be it indeed. Draco just has so many cooldowns, though, with those shell spikes. Frostyek has Blink. Fear No Evil still down, but Spudio lands a root.
Draco Marino's low. They can't chase this for too long, and they don't have to. A nice sash comes out from Bree, biding his time in the stealth, but still out cold, playing this one slow. They now have a mini wave moving in. This might be what they were waiting for, and now they can take their opportunity. Demi on the actual Titan. Final Judgment just deletes Warchi from the game. Titan down to half HP. That's a deicide, and out cold gaming finally at 67 and a half minutes of play. Take the set.
Fastest 67 minutes of my life. Out cold gaming with a deicide and ends up 5-0. And Frostyek does so much, but that last team fight, really all the credit in my mind goes to Breeze. Breeze had a sick sash onto Worst Turtle.